The PSD division in the Seattle office is primarily the home and heart of PSOC. We have many features of the business unit all in one location, which gives us a big advantage of being, co-located. We have everywhere from applications.
We help to specify new products and solutions, do feasibility studies, and create solutions from scratch. We produce all the documentation for using our chips.
We have the actual designers.
What we build are analog programmable systems for PSOC and MCU parts.
We have the programmable digital group.
My team works on programmable digital systems and programmable analog systems that go into our PSOC family.
We have all the product and test engineers.
We define all of the next generation microcontrollers, as well as we launch those microcontrollers into the market.
The systems engineering group works with product development to make sure we have all of the features required to launch the project out into the world.
My group develops production test programs and hardware for all of our chips that we make. We do all the coding, simulations, hardware design, checkout, debug, test time reduction, and then release that into production.
So we're all basically a one-stop shop for making some of the most complicated SoCs in the world.
You get everything with Washington. You have the ocean, you have the mountains, you get a great city, you get a great local scene. It's an awesome place to live.
It rains every single day here in Seattle, and that's what we'll tell everyone that's from California thinking about moving up.
A lot of people think that it rains all the time in Seattle, and it doesn't actually do that. It also snows in the winter, and so
it never rains in Seattle. It's just this perpetual drizzle somewhere between October and May. So you get summers that are the most beautiful weather in the world.
The reason we're located in here in Seattle is historical.
IC Design started as a software company doing integrated circuit CAD tools. Over time, we began to do individual products, and especially we found an opportunity to do clock generator chips, and that company was acquired by Cypress Semiconductor in about 1993.
As that became part of Cypress, we also came across another company called Cypress Microsystems, which we funded. And so both those came together in a single office in 1999.
We started a USB microcontroller line at the time. One of the first USB microcontrollers we did, it was a USB mouse. And this was a Microsoft mouse. Inside the mouse was the Cypress microcontroller, the only chip. This was their last ball mouse. After this, they went to the LEDs.
Cypress realized that they had a microcontroller line for USBs, and they wanted to expand that into the general purpose microcontroller market. But they realized that the competition had hundreds, and in some cases thousands, of devices. So instead, they figured out that if we made a programmable chip, we could come out with one device or a small number of devices that could be programmed into those hundreds of devices.
I started at Cypress January of 2000, which was right at the beginning of the startup. And what we were doing there is building our first PSOC chip. The initial PSOC chip was successful from a functional standpoint, but we had to work out a lot of bugs. And so we went from first chip to the second chip, Diamond, and that chip actually was good enough that we were able to sell it mass market. One of those chips hit it big with Apple.
From 2005 until today, 2016, we've done PSOC 1, filled out a family, 12 to 13 parts. We've made PSOC 3, which was our next generation of analog. We've made PSOC 4, and now into starting with PSOC 6. All this within the same building, same confines, same people, all working together. It's been a very enjoyable ride.
Seahawks!
Washington is special in that it was a number of small startups that Cypress acquired. Even though we're now a very large facility with an awful lot of people, we still have that startup culture. You know, Friday in the summer, if the weather is nice, we'll pull out the grill.
I've been at Cypress for just under 24 years.
Almost 8 years. 16 years.
20 years.
14 years.
I've stayed at Cypress because the job is exciting, it's challenging, and I work with really great people that I really enjoy just hanging out with.
I feel like Cypress is my family, and I enjoy working with the people I work with.
Ultimately, it's the people and the culture. There's always new and challenging projects to work on, and you have a strong team to work on them with.
We've got cutting-edge design teams. We have very innovative, forward-thinking marketing groups, so it's a great site to be at with really fantastic people.
This group works a lot together. Everybody can work together so efficiently, and everybody brings so many different skill sets, and everyone has that knowledge.
Cypress is very much a company about personal responsibility, telling the truth, and Washington embraces that as much as any site inside the corporation. When you own something, you must make sure that it gets done. And people on site really take that to heart. I'm very proud as the mega site owner about how much we're integrated with the company. We believe in the core values. We all pull for one another. Everybody on site politically wants to have our site do well, and that's a big win for us.